Stop guilt tripping him into...
We don't guilt trip him, buddy.
You gonna let me talk?
Yeah, go right ahead.
Ryan's never been there for him. Ryan has never been there for him.
You know what? I'm sorry,
Taylor. We're not doing this.
Come on.
You need to step back. Taylor. Stop. Taylor. You need to step back.
Sorry, son of a...
Katie from Without a Crystal Ball. Welcome back to my channel. Teen Mom OG's reunion last night was, oh my goodness. It was a mess. Honestly, I didn't watch any of the segments other than Amber and Maci because I don't care about the other people on the show anymore. I just don't. They don't interest me. I'm done. And I was waiting to see how everything was going to go down with Taylor and Larry. And honestly, it really was not like how it was described when I spoke to my source. It was a lot different, and it seemed like this was a situation where Taylor walked into the situation angry, and Larry walked into the situation angry, and those two worlds collided. And I think Taylor said what a lot of fans have been thinking and have been waiting for someone to say on behalf of Bentley. And when I shared a clip on my Instagram of what Taylor was saying, all of you guys were like, yes, yes, yes. So what actually happened? In the clip with Maci, she did talk about everything that happened with that incident that she was involved in, and she was talking about different methods that she's using through therapy to help with the trauma that she's been experiencing as a result of that. So after she talked about everything that happened at the gas station, Taylor came onto the set, and he was ready to go. Like, he was amped up, and I've never seen Taylor like this on a reunion. And it starts off with him basically saying, like, I think you're seeing that Bentley is growing up, that Bentley has finally found his voice, and that Bentley is not going to let the Edwards make him feel any sort of way about his father.
He's found his voice. He has a voice. He can think for himself.
And then, he also took issue with Ryan and his appearance on the
when
show.
When you watch a new episode, you think Ryan can't possibly be any dumber than he is, and he will prove you wrong the next week?
Taylor came right out swinging, obviously, and he talked about the issues with Ryan looking dumb and looking dumber, and then talked about his appearance, and then also took aim at Ryan for calling Maci a B.
Y'all saw the clip. You know, he sat there and called my wife a bitch.
And then he also seemed really, really upset about the way that Ryan treats Bentley. He doesn't like that Ryan belittles him, makes fun of him, that he doesn't think that Ryan treats his son very well, and doesn't think that Ryan is a good father, like, at all.
You know, calling him a crybaby. Enough's enough. Grow up and be a man. You know, come sit out here. Don't be a coward.
He was particularly angry with Ryan calling Bentley a crybaby, and he basically was like, dude, Ryan, you've got to grow up. Be a man. They also admitted that Ryan refuses to talk to them, and so they say that they would speak to Ryan, but Ryan will not talk to them, and he says that Ryan says that Maci is a trigger, and so Ryan will avoid all confrontation. Now, when I spoke to Mackenzie, I think she told me that Ryan doesn't want to deal with Taylor and his temper. So I don't know. I tend to believe that Ryan doesn't want to face the music. It seems like he just doesn't want to deal with his shortcomings. He doesn't want to acknowledge that he is ultimately failing as a father and has failed as a father. And if he spoke to Maci and to Taylor, he would have to confront the fact that he has put himself first. He has not been there for his son, and his addiction took hold of him. Now, Dr. Drew did say that, you know, he has this debilitating addiction, and he was trying to offer him some grace with that.
So he has had a dangerous, life-threatening substance use disorder. Do you think he's sober now?
And then Taylor says, you know, he can barely hold his eyes open on set. He's in a scene. He doesn't look like he's, like, at all taking care of himself. And they ask, like, do you think that Ryan's using? And they both believe that Ryan is not sober.
That's not a place that I feel safe to send our son with that guy.
And they said they don't have any confirmation other than visually what they see when they look at the show. And they said it's hard for them to believe, based on his physical appearance, that he could be sober. And I tend to agree with that. I don't think he's sober, but Mackenzie insists that he is. And, you know, I believe in what she believes. Who knows? So after he goes on about how Mr. Bentley is not being treated well by his dad and that Ryan might be using again, Jen and Larry come on and they talk about whether or not they've seen Bentley and what the relationship is like with Bentley. And Jen tries to be very diplomatic and she's like, you know, we don't see him as much as we want, but we understand that he's very busy with school and he's in his sports and we enjoy when we can see him. And then they asked Larry about his tabloid talk and Larry got like really defensive, like right off the bat. He's like, what article? So Dr. Drew's like, well, you told the tabloids that Maci is limiting the visits between you and Bentley. And then he's like, yeah, well, she is limiting some. And it gets to a point where it starts to get a little bit more escalated.
She's limited some, sure. I don't know if I'm blaming her for it, but yeah, I think she's, you know, some of the things that are going on.
He's like, I don't know if I'm really blaming you for it. I don't really know. But then that is what really sets off Taylor, because he's like, you know, she has bent over backwards for you. She has always tried to make sure that you have a relationship with the son and with your grandson. And you consistently like are putting your son before them.
Bent over backwards to make sure that Bentley kept a relationship with them through everything that Ryan has put us through.
You know, Taylor's trying to stick up for Maci. Macy's not really saying much. And then Dr. Drew then confronts Larry again. And he's just like, well, you kind of said that you felt like Maci is putting things in Bentley's head about you guys, which is affecting your relationship. And then Larry's like, I didn't really say that. I mean, all I said was that kids can be manipulated at that age.
I didn't say against.
Okay.
What I said is that a 12-year-old boy can be manipulated.
Yes.
And then Maci tries to be very, like, even in her response. And she's like, I don't feel like I've been trying to manipulate him. I've always given him the opportunity to do, like, what he does and what he wants to do.
I did not know that existed. Like, I didn't know that that's how y'all felt.
And then, you know, she just talks about how she's always tried to have an open policy with them, an open relationship with them. But it's really hard with Ryan. And part of it is because of their codependence with Ryan. And Jen's like, you know, you don't understand. I mean, I'm sure if you had a child that was going through this, you would understand how hard this is to have a son that has this addiction and you don't want to ever give up on them. And that is actually kind of what ends up getting Taylor into a tailspin.
Are we sure?
You think that I've done?
Don't you buck up to me.
Look, I'm going to tell you.
Tell me.
Taylor then feels like they are making it seem like Ryan's addiction and his disease is being placed in front of Bentley. And they feel like Taylor does that when Bentley is with them, he is being put into a position where they're forcing a relationship with Ryan that Bentley is not comfortable having, or that Bentley should not be responsible for engaging in.
Stop. When you're forcing him, stop. When y'all are showing up to something,
stop.
And you're telling him,
stop.
Go over there and give your dad a hug. Go take a picture with your dad. Bentley is a child.
So, like, he says, you know, you always make them be like, Bentley, go take a picture. Go say hi to your dad. Go do this with your dad. When it's not Ryan, like, Ryan, go engage with your son. Basically saying you can't put that all on the child. And I actually agreed with him. Like, it's not Bentley's responsibility to ensure that he has a relationship with his father. It's Ryan's. And his parents trying to facilitate it through Bentley just shows how much of an enabler they are to Ryan. Like, well, Ryan, if you don't try, we'll just do it for you. So you don't have a relationship, so we're gonna put Bentley in a position, almost like using Bentley as a vehicle to their enabling. Like, Bentley doesn't have a relationship with his dad, but we feel guilty about that, so Bentley, go see your dad. Bentley, go talk to your dad. And I'm sure that makes Bentley feel like he is responsible to repair the damage in this relationship that it's not his fault in creating. And Taylor is like going off about how he's never been there for Bentley. He is not a father. He is a grown adult. Like, he needs to man up and do something.
Yeah, go right ahead.
Ryan's never been there for him. Ryan has never been there for him. But y'all put it on Bentley. Y'all make Bentley feel guilty.
Let me tell you what. Y'all, where were you at in the first 3 years of his life?
So then they also talked about something that happened 3 years ago on the phone as well between Taylor, and apparently Taylor went off on Ryan. So there seems to be a history of Ryan and Taylor having altercations. And I think Taylor's anger is, you could tell that Maci wanted him to calm down, but you could also tell that she was in a way kind of relieved that this was finally coming to heads. And I think it's really clear in what's going on here. Taylor is protecting Bentley. And sometimes when you are in protection mode, you are in mama bear or papa bear, I kind of call it. Like, all of your calmness exits and all of your reasonable, rational behavior is gone, and you just go into protection mode, and you will do whatever you can to protect that child, to ensure that that child is taken care of, that his child is not hurt. And if you have a child that goes to a father's house and then he has his dad calling him a crybaby, making him feel bad, mocking him, doing all that stuff, you have grandparents that are making him feel guilty, you can see where Taylor might feel like this isn't healthy. And then you have Bentley coming home and not feeling good about it and feeling upset. So it just creates this massive power dynamic and issue. And I honestly feel like, as much as Jen and Larry have tried to help this situation, I feel like their codependence and enabling of Ryan has just actually fractured this relationship and made it worse. I think if they would have just stayed out of it and allowed Ryan to make his mistakes and not been the go-between to try to foster a relationship to ensure that their addicted son had a part of this child's life, there would be maybe a very different position where Ryan might have had to man up. Ryan might have had to grow up, but Ryan didn't grow up, and Ryan still isn't growing up. Ryan is still seemingly not doing much with his life, and as much as Mackenzie says that he's sober, I don't believe that, and he hasn't taken steps. I know he says he's got a shop now and they're going to be fine financially, but I really don't know how. Like, what work experience does Ryan have at this point in time when all he's done for 10 years is go in and out of jail and deal with a very serious addiction, and then also have parents that enable that addiction, a wife that enables the addiction, and he has no real consequences outside of going to jail. And that sometimes still doesn't clean people up. I mean, if jail cleaned people up, everyone that gets arrested for drugs would be clean. It's not an answer. They need therapy, and Ryan doesn't seemingly want to do a real program at all. And his parents and his wife, and nobody seems to care. And I can't blame them now to put their foot down and be like, we don't feel safe sending him there. We don't want to send him there, and he shouldn't have to go. Can you blame them? So it's going to continue to the next episode, and apparently it's going to get even more physical or more threatening. But I actually was like on team Taylor and Maci, and I don't have anything really to say about Jen and Larry. And honestly, I'm glad they got fired for this. To be honest, like, Larry running to the tabloids, all of this just creates chaos for him. And nobody, I mean, even Dr. Drew said that, like, the way Taylor was handling things didn't have Bentley's best interests in mind. But with Taylor, I just saw somebody that has been fed up for 9 years coming to a head. That's what it felt like to me. Like, he's finally exploded. He can't hold back.
Cordy, you want me to play right now? Put the kid first. Stop putting that sorry excuse of a human being first.
So what did you think about it? Were you surprised, shocked? Or were you like, finally, someone said it? Tell me in the comments below. Bye, guys.